Hi everyone, thanks for coming back to the channel. So as promised, I'm going to show you another of my machines. Now we only bought this yesterday, so we're super excited about it. And for those that don't know, it is a Fred Bolland's Gipsy Fortune Teller machine. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can have a look in detail and have a see what's in it. So the top of it is wood, and the front of it is a cast metal. Well, I think these are the castings, and I think from what I believe, this is steel. They did this to make them so they could go outside. Now, the older machines, they have wood, but the newer ones, like made from the 1950s onwards, they would have been all cast because they were mainly out in piers and things like that. So we'll move in and have a look up here. We have Bolland's Amusement Machine, Supply Co Limited, and that shows you that it's a London based company. And this machine is number 184. Looks like it's got a little bit of yellow on there as well. So as you can probably see, it's pretty knackered, for want of a better word. It still works well. We've been having a play with it, Chris and I, but there's lots of like chips on it and so forth that'll need tweaking. Here originally would have been a plaque, and the plaque was really cool. It said something like, if you want me to read a fortune, come and spend a penny. So we'd probably like to try and get hold of, or get, you know, Chris might do a bit of sign writing and try and get that plaque's wording in at least. Here's where the penny slot is, obviously. And then we're going to go to the artwork. Now, the artwork is really intricate. It's on a large circular disc with a mirrored, with a glass front. And I'm going to go zooming in a bit for you here, because the artwork is super. It's got like an old Romany gypsy lady there. And what I do love is about the arrow. It's got that, this little moon on it and the arrow up here. And then we'll have a look what it says on the way round. She's also got cards in her hand as well. And we've got things like health, lose money, divorce, which is interesting actually, because I think this machine, with it being one of the older ones, quite likely would have been World War II. So divorce being on there is quite a surprise. Unexpected news awaits you. Enemies. You make friends too easily. I would have thought that's pretty good, really. A baby on a way, an offer of marriage, sickness, a lucky day is near, a lover wishes gratified, riches. You can see that was the last one we had, so let's hope that's true. A present is coming, a ring, you will travel. I think that says happiness, surprises in store, a proposal, wealth coming, trouble, you will regain what you have lost, changes, a second lover, oh that's a bit risque, a husband, long life, many friends, deceit, misfortune is coming, hope, a second marriage. Do we already have a second marriage? Oh, a second lover, it must have turned into another marriage. Accidents, a broken engagement, health, and we're back down to lose money again. So, I mean, some of these are quite severe, aren't they? I would imagine if you were having a go on it and you really believed in it, you know, it would be quite horrible if you ended up getting that, well, misfortune is coming. It's quite dire, that one, isn't it? So I'm going to show you around the sides. And see lots of the woods kind of chipped off and so forth. I'll just take my time circling around it. Unfortunately, with it having the glass front, it's obviously mirroring back onto the film here. Now, this is interesting, and I'll talk a bit more about that in a minute. This hole here would not have been here normally. So this probably indicates better to you where it would metal. And then around the back is just flaked off wood as well. So should we have a go of it? And then I'll tell you why that hole is super interesting. And also, while I'm doing this, it's on an old penny play. I shall let you know that this will be one of the first of our renovation projects. So it should be looking a lot nicer over the next couple of weeks if you're watching. So I'm going to put a penny in, see what it is now. Watch it be misfortune. And it spins. And I've got a ring. Well, I'll never say no to a ring. Clog eye is my favourite. If anybody's listening, hint, hint. We'll have another couple of goes. again, and it works just on like a kind of a spinning mechanism. So it's really easy, and I know there used to be adverts for this, sorry for all the ums, and the adverts would say the one good thing about this Gipsy Fortune teller machine is that you didn't have to put cards in, because obviously some of the penny arcade machines, the fortune tellers, all had cards on them, whereas this doesn't. Now, I've used a lot of information from this fabulous book, and it's called Arcades and Slot Machines. And it's by Paul Braithwaite, and I highly recommend it if you love arcade machines, especially if you're collecting old ones such as this. I'm going to show you, actually, the one lovely thing we saw in this book was the fact that it had a picture of all the machines together, how they would have looked once they were on a pier. And it shows quite easily how strong they would have looked. And I believe that they were made to withstand shocking weather, which you probably would have had in a pier. And this is what it was called originally, the ironclad. And I'm going to zoom in and show it you. So it was an all-weather automatic fortune machine. They did three of them by the looks of things. One was called the Predictor, the Heaven and Hell, which I kind of like, actually. I have seen it. I think I saw it at Wookie Hole, and I really love that one. And ours, which is the Gipsy. Now, as you can see, there's that little plaque that we are missing on ours, which said you spend a penny. Everything else is there. And according to this little bit of an advert, they would have been painted in Egyptian green marbling. So yeah, we might try and do something like that. So there's a little bit of history for it. So the one exciting thing we found out about this is that it's actually been used as a film prop. Now, it's a while ago, so if you've any youngsters listening in, you might not have even heard of these names. But Michael Caine and Laurence Olivier starred in a movie called Sleuth, and it was in 1972. I think there has been a reissue of it, but it's not the one that's the reissue. You need the, if you want to watch it, it's on YouTube, and I will put the link down below in the description so you can have a look, because there's other machines in that film as well, so it's nice looking around. And yeah, this movie, we found out that this was the very machine that was used in that movie. So you should be able to see it. So of course, the quandary we've got now is, do we renovate it and keep it as an original? Or do we stick to it as it is and just sympathetically put it, you know, tidy it up a little bit, but keep it with this, you know, because the originals, obviously me saying they would have been marbled. This has been painted over in this brown colour to match the, you know, the wood. And I think that would have been done for the movie, because if you have a look at the movie clip, which obviously, as I said, I'll send you the link, and I'm going to explain this hole now. Yeah, so this hole here, they'd placed, the prop people, I imagine, had placed a handle in it. So to all intents and purposes, they turned the Gipsy Fortune Teller into a one-armed bandit. And I don't know how you feel about it. If you go and watch the clip, it's fairly early on in the film. It doesn't really work to me, because obviously most people know that these fortune tellers don't have one-armed bandits handles on them. The one thing I did like about the movie was some interesting points, like the dial here with this nice little moon crescent here and the arrow. They've taken this bit off in the movie, and then you saw it, you go back and see it spinning again. So that must have been, I mean, they're not easy things to take off, are they? They've got like a nut and bolt there, and you have to dismantle it all. And then you only see it back on when Michael Caine gets his Gipsy Fortune and it says a proposal to him. So there's a good sleuthy kind of detective movie for you to watch on a Sunday afternoon. So I'm going to back out now, and then I'm going to pass this over to my husband Chris, who does all the renovations. But I would love to know what your thoughts are. Now we know it's a film prop from, you know, quite a esteemed film. Would you keep it as it is and just tidy it up a little bit? Or would you try and get it back to its original with the marbled green and so forth, and, you know, try and make it as authentic as it would have been as it came out the factory? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section. I'd be really interested to read. Right, I shall sign off for a minute, and then I'll pass you over to Chris.
Hello everybody, Zelda's bought me another project by the looks of it. I picked it up yesterday from Leamington Spa from the Elephant House. This is an early version of this particular machine. Got a wooden top. They were later replaced with aluminium top, and I think it was a cast iron bottom, cast iron front on it. And this one's just got wooden sides. Like I say, with it being early, it's got a fair bit of damage to it. I'll just turn it around quickly. As you can see, the back needs replacing. There's no verb in it though, which is good. So we've got a bit of a renovation to do on it. I'll just put it back round there. It's not too heavy really for a machine as you go. And we get the magic key. Hopefully we can have a quick look inside and see what it's all about. As you can see, there's not a lot to it. I'll turn this round and show you quickly how it works, hopefully. Place a penny in the slot. Drop down, that goes round there. As you can see, when it goes round, the little smaller cog still keeps on spinning freely, which basically the fingers of the clock is attached to. So it's very random. It'll go one way and then it goes the other, depending. And it's very finely balanced. Very simple. It works a treat. Right, what can I say about the inside? Basically, we've got to rebuild it. It's falling away from its...
Oh, lots of pennies there, though. It must be a good burner.
Yes, yeah, I'm going to charge you for them after. A little bit of a renovation here. You can see where the handle came through when they did it as a film prop. We don't know an awful lot about that, but it was a little bit flimsy. I think there's a bracket over here. Could have been a piece of elastic going to the handle and maybe... made the handle recall when you pull it.
Oh yeah, there's something there, isn't there? Like you said, yeah. Just bracketed on.
So basically, I'm going to strip it, take it all apart, replace the back, probably have to replace the bottom with a piece of oak, and put it back as it originally was.
Well, that's if people think it should be. Because I don't know, because if it being a film prop, are we going to, but you know, I'm not saying it's going to be butchered. It's obviously not. It's going to look fantastic if you're doing it. But I just wonder if you lose the whole cachet of it being a film prop then, would it just actually be a Bolland's, you know?
Yes, but we do have a working arcade and it's got to be practical.
That is true.
And solid.
Yeah.
There's no point in taking it out with the box falling to bits.
No, no. So at the very least, we could just at least make it sturdier and, you know.
As you can see, that is the original colour probably. And it's been wood grained, which I used to do a lot of because I was a decorator for 20 odd years. So I'm quite good at wood graining.
Yeah, so we could take it back to the prop, the look of it as a prop, couldn't we?
Yeah, or re-wood grain the front.
Yeah.
We've got a choice, really. And I dare say when we take the outer cowling of the clock off, we'll find out what colour it is under there originally.
Oh, yeah, that is a point. Yeah, you probably will do, won't you?
Yeah.
So is that what you're planning on doing? So, yeah, if you've heard that, those two plans, let me know what you think would be the best.
And watch out for part two.
Yes, watch out for part two. That normally comes. The renovation ones we're going to be fitting in once a month, just because of obviously renovation takes a while. So yeah, that will be coming. This will be out. We're on Sunday today, aren't we? So this will be Sunday. So next month will come part two. Okay, hope you enjoyed the video. If you'd like to say goodbye, Chris.
See you soon. Don't forget to subscribe and like our page, please.
That's great. Take care, everybody. Bye.